In this episode, we're installing the motherboard.
You're watching IT Pro TV.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in to more of the hands-on PC build. That's right. We've got an exciting episode for you today. In fact, this is the day we get to install our motherboard. So fun, exciting times to be had by all. However, before we get too excited about things, one of the things that I want you to make sure that you do, we got to talk a little bit about the case and one of the ways that you can protect the motherboard from actually touching the case and grounding out. So let's look here at the bench here, a bird's eye view. You're going to see that what we did ahead of time is we've got the case open, and you're going to notice that there are a couple of these points here, and then a couple of these screw holes are actually missing what are called standoffs, all right? And that is an uncommon thing. It's kind of very common that these cases will fit slight variations of the ATX standard there. Forgot the acronym. For instance, like extended ATX. Ours didn't need these, so we went ahead and removed them ahead of time. But we have six standoffs left. And to kind of see, if we look at the tech cam here, you can kind of see how these standoffs work. They actually raise up. They keep the motherboard raised up off the sidewall of the case. And that's going to be something that's very, very important, because we don't want the bottom of the motherboard and all the solder points to actually touch the side of the case, or it's going to ground out, and unfortunately it's going to arc and it's going to short circuit and it's going to cause damage to the motherboard, and we certainly don't want that. Another thing I'll say too, if we take a look here, is that the fan that we had was actually on the back of the case, you know, the intake fan, and well, it was getting in the way of the back panel being able to seat in there fully, so I went ahead and just took it off so that we can set our motherboard in here a little bit easier and not have to worry about this fan. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to set this to the side. And what do you say we go ahead and we lay our motherboard down inside of this case? Now here, as I go to install and seat the motherboard here, I'm just going to very gently lay it down inside of the case here. And we're going to go ahead and kind of just arrange it. And what if we look at the tech cam here, you're going to see that the back I/O panel actually comes into view. And that's what we want here. We want to make sure that that back panel slides right in. And this is one of the beauties about the ATX standard, is that it should slide into place fairly easy. And when that happens, that allows us the ability to go ahead and the next step, screw these motherboards down and the mounting points. And it lines up all of those mounting points, and they should line up pretty darn well. So we've got our case or our motherboard already laid down here. Now what do you say we're going to go ahead and we're going to put some of the screws in. And I'm going to use some of our handy dandy lights here that we had beforehand. So I'm going to turn them on because, it gets kind of dark in here. In these cases, it gets kind of hard to see, and we want you to be able to see what we're doing here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take the first screw, and we're going to put it in the mounting point back here, and just take your time, just kind of like you maybe seen in the power supply episode. If they don't line right up, just kind of move the motherboard around a little bit, and they should slide right into place. You should be okay. And again, you can see I'm going to probably have to move the motherboard around a little bit. I will tell you that when you screw these in, don't screw them in too tight. You don't want to do that. We'll go ahead and put in the next one, because you don't want to crack the motherboard. But at the same time, you want to use all of the standoffs that you have available to you, because this prevents vibration in the case. So I'm going to go ahead and just screw this one down, and we'll get that locked down into place. And then we've got a couple more mounting points right here. So I'll just finish that. We're going to go ahead and do the next one here. And the good thing is this iFixit kit that I'm using, the screws kind of stick to it. Now, it isn't magnetic. We want to be careful with anything that magnets around, you know, anything inside of your case, or it would defeat the purpose of having your anti-static wrist straps on. And we've got a couple more here, so I'm going to do the one. It's actually kind of, let me pull the CPU fan out of the way. We haven't connected that yet, because we're going to do that in a connections episode when we get all of our connections going and connected down. So we're going to take the next one, and we'll go ahead and screw this one down. And that's four out of the six. We've got two to go, and these are actually down here on the other side of the motherboard here. And I can't stress this enough, make sure you use all of the mounting points for your case. That is important because if you don't do that, well, again, it tends to lead to vibration that could cause damage. And the other thing I can say too is don't leave any unused standoffs. You want to take them out. If they're not meant for your motherboard, do not leave them in there. It looks like I dropped a screw. I'll take care of that, and we'll get that out of there once we get the other screw in place. So last one here to go, and we'll get this one screwed in. And we'll screw that down, and there we go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it didn't take really that much. It's as simple as that to get your motherboard installed. We've got all of our mount points ready to go. And, well, if we take a look here, we've got it installed. We've actually installed our motherboard. We've got all of the mounting points are lined up. That's what we need. Didn't really take that much. Again, don't force it. You certainly don't want to break your motherboard in any way. You don't want to crack anything. So just be patient with it. Make sure you've got all those mounting points and those standoffs so you don't get grounding. And that's how you install your motherboard.
Thank you for watching IT Pro TV.